Wait, I ain't ready. Why, go start with the other guys to work over to me. I gotta drink this water. Start with the other guys and get them, you know, get to talking and I'll walk over to you. Go ahead. Azreal means the death angel in charge of the heavens of hell here on earth.
Necker's way you make your father said.
Hey, Francis. My name is Azreal, and I've got a story to tell.
I'm guilty, Your Honor. I think black people are God.
Yeah, but he's right. Wise man can play the fool, but a fool can't be a wise man.
Yeah, I'ma twist up another one, though.
Go ahead, yo.
Take nothing on face value. Examine everything. That's how we was taught by Almighty God Allah.
Azreal is what? Azreal is the original man. He's like a devil to me. Use that.
But anybody that says that I'm the devil that the Father taught, how wrong they could be. He was born in 1928. I was born on September 28th, 1948, 20 years and 6 months to the day.
Where was I born? Queens Boulevard Hospital, Long Island.
Your 360 is what makes you God. And any genius only uses 3/4 of 1 ounce of their brain. So you got all that untapped shit. Father taught me, that's life's lesson, super subconscious. I was there when the first Allah's World Manifest was written by Robert Walker, a.k.a. Allah the Son, a.k.a. Al-Azhar, a.k.a. whatever he started as the Black Muslim Sons when they wouldn't let him fill the father's shoes. They wouldn't let A.L.R. Harry, his younger brother, the taxi cab drivers, fill his shoes. There would only be one father ever. The father said, matter one is for the maddest ones on the planet.
Why were you a Matterhorn?
I went to Matterhorn from Elmira. Bugged out over cigarettes. I bugged out at Elmira Reception Center when they put me in isolation and I couldn't smoke cigarettes. Instead of rushing me with the mattress and the straps, I said, come on, motherfucker, you wouldn't let me smoke, come on, let's fight. The first day I was there, January 1st, 1966, I came out of isolation. They put you naked in a room with a little pot to piss and shit in. And they know everybody their first day don't want to squat and shit in the pot. So they just pee. So they know that. So with their steel-toed shoes, you know, every morning, they let a guy out. They know what he's going to do. His routine is so comical to them. They're going to reach for their piss pot. And when they do, they're going to leave themselves right here vulnerable for a kick. So they're going to give that kick with the steel tip. Bam! And that food they fed you the night before and that morning, bam, is going to shoot the fuck out your ass. And they're going to laugh at you. And that's going to be your first experience of knuckle therapy. The first 14 days you're in Matterhorn, you're treated with what they call knuckle therapy. In the old days, when it was built during the Civil War, Matterhorn was, for the criminally insane, the most advanced asylum. And what they had for treatment instead of knuckle therapy was hanging patients or prisoners. Patients, really. You know, off the floor, 6 inches off the floor by shackles. So most of those patients were black then, and they were mostly black that now. The first day I'm getting them, he walked over to me. I was sitting in the care, in the chair, coming out of a 3-day coma from the hospital ward. They gave me my last rites then, the first time. But I came back, and he walked over 40 feet from across the room, left hand to there, and said, "You are a righteous man. Do you know who I am?" So I said, "You must be God." I thought he was, you know, he knew I was righteous. I knew I was righteous because Superman, all the superheroes, they were my role models. I beat up bullies. I took joy in it. When I was in Jamesburg, I said, "Who's the fucking Duke? I want to fight the baddest motherfucker, and I work my way up to him. Just get that shit done. You know, don't fuck with that crazy motherfucker." So, at the time, anyway, Father walked up to me and said, "You are a righteous man. Do you know who I am?" I said, "You must be God." He said, "My name is Allah. I'm a leg on my head. I'm going to use supreme mathematics and knowledge of everything in the universe." I said, "Can I call you Father?" And he said, "Yes, son." Not my son, yes, son. So right there we were begotten to each other. Chosen, it means the word begotten.
But when the Father first spoke to Azreal, and Azreal would tell you that the Father recognized him as a righteous man because the persecution that Azreal was going through. And the Father asked Azreal, did he know who he was? And Azreal told him, yeah, he was God.
I said, "You must be God," because I felt he was reading my mind. And I could see the love and the light in his eyes.
See, Azreal, he comes back from the days of the Father when he was in Matawan State Institution for the Criminally Insane, which he came upon one of our associates, and we call beloved brothers. Because he's white, you may think, "Oh, why could you call somebody brother," whatever. This is Allah's chosen, which we call death angel. That's what the name Azreal means. His bloodline is of royalty. He comes from John F. Kennedy. His name is John F. Kennedy, legally.
John Michael Kennedy.
Well,
the third.
Yeah, the third.
I had the name before President Kennedy.
See, it even goes deeper than that. And he's chosen from Allah himself.
First time I got kicked in the pelvis was in Matawan by Clarence Darrow, who was the Grand Dragon for the Ku Klux Klan and the DOC, the correctional officers that were doing jailhouse murders. 1989, he could kick around like 360 on one foot without getting off the foot like a rooster. A wise man can play a fool. Why would a wise man play a fool unless he was dealing with assholes? All assholes come from the planet Uranus. That's where Colin Powell, George Bush, and Condoleezza Rice. I call it Condoleezza Rice because I believe if he didn't tell mommy and daddy and even Laura that she was giving them blowjobs to Baghdad because she got a lip reduction, a nose reduction, you know, the whole nine yards. She wants to be Condoleezza White Rice. Ah! Oh shit, Carolina too! Oh no, black beans in the stew! Ah! Yeah, fuck with me, man, I'll tell the truth. And they brought WWE wrestling to the fucking holiest Islamic land, the fucking scummiest sport on earth. There's an insult to all the goddamn true and living Islamic people who can't stand cursing, and they bring wrestling to the airbase. What the fuck is that? It's not a fucking slap in the face to every true Muslim. And at the same time, when he was kneeling with his father and the dead Pope was there, he looked like a cockeyed rooster, and he should be dead. So I grew up my juvenile life, 78% of it, in institutions. From Sacred Heart Orphanage, Boys Town, Menlo Park, their own parental home. Not that I committed crimes,
I was playing habitual hooky player to keep my brothers and sisters out of the orphanage. I went shining shoes because back then, if the state found out your family was sick or dead, they'd put you in the orphanage. There was no programs. So I started shoe shining. That was my first major crime. Back then, they hunted you down if you didn't go to school. Now, teachers have a pot party if you don't show up.
That's real. I mean, he's the first Caucasian, 5%. You know, he was taught by the father of law. When the father of law was in Matawan, you know, young man by the name of John Kennedy came in there. You know, he witnessed some things, the treachery of the guards and all that in Matawan. And, you know, he got fucked up himself. When he woke up, Allah was standing above him. Allah said, "Do you know who I am?" He said, "You must be God." With him ever since, and he taught him, you know, and it just goes to show that, you know, we're not about, oh, I hate the white man, or, you know, this and that. We hate devilishment. We hate oppression. We hate wickedness. We love righteousness. We love good. We love, you know, positivity.
How was Azreal received in the 60s?
Well, Azreal was received in the 60s first as a novelty, a curiosity. Up until that time, we had never embraced or accepted a Caucasian amongst us, right? We had embraced and accepted some of our Latin brothers who may have had European blood in them and even looked European. But by virtue of them being Puerto Rican, even Cuban, or even Dominican, and raised in lands where there was, you know, predominant portion of black people and had black culture and black ways and black expressions, that their mindset was that of the original man. So when they got the teachings, their mindset was that of a original man, thus righteous, and we accepted them as such. But Azreal, for me and for many of us, was the first Caucasian that came amongst us to embrace knowledge of himself. And he didn't embrace knowledge of himself being taught that he was a god or anything of that nature. He embraced knowledge of himself being taught the truth, that he was a Caucasian child, and thus was he born a devil, meaning his nature was due wickedness, to be weak and wicked, because he was weak-boned and weak-blooded. But under the right supervision, he was taught to hold all of that in check and deal with the strengths of himself as opposed to the weakness of himself.
So the devil doesn't just exist in one race. The devil exists within all of us. It all determines on what you decide to let dominate in your life. There's yin and yang in everything, positive and negative in everything. Nothing's 100% positive, nothing's 100% negative. But you have to decide which one is going to dominate your life. And do you want to live as God or do you want to live as devil? So Azreal decided he wanted to live as God. Once he met Allah in the flesh. And so, you know, he's been with us ever since.
I met Azreal approximately 30 years ago. He came to the school. Once when Sabu and I was caretakers of the school, and he it was cold and he needed some clothing, particularly a winter coat, which we obliged him with. And I had questioned him as to where he had been all these years, and he told me that he was had some difficulties. And he was living in Jersey off and on with his parents. I was always puzzled as to why the father taught Azreal. another year that I've learned to understand why. And I accept Azreal as a man who loves our way of life. When I say our way of life, the gods and earth.
Father taught him the truth. And the truth was, the white man is the devil. He was born to get the worst out of the original man. Yeah, he was a seed within us, and we got the worst out of him.
That was the two pieces of steel that he was playing with, the right and the wrong. One good and one bad. Then you had the black man saying at that day and time there was no bad in him. And Yaku said, there is bad in you, and I'm going to prove it, because I'm going to graft it out of you. Because if it's not in you, I can't graft it out of you. So once he manifested that something could come out of you that was different than you, so was culture, so was attitude, and so was your behavior. So also negative behavior came out of the people. And the negative behavior is what we call devilishment today.
Did you get down on tape how I first went to the school? That was my favorite day. Father had told me 7th Avenue, the Urban League Street Academy, and I wasn't sure what street. I had never been to Hall. So, but I couldn't shake my family. My family knew I wanted to come up here, but I didn't want to bring them up here with me because I was worried that they might get hurt. I wasn't worried about me. But in other words, it wasn't until February during that blizzard that I finally, you know, everybody was in the house and asleep and I could get away.
The blizzard was really bad. The roads were all iced up. Wind was blowing, hail was coming down, and that's the day my family left me alone, so I figured I'd come over now.
I got down to Port Authority, and, you know, it was the street, the sidewalks, everything was snowed, ice over, you know, the streets, the sidewalks, all iced up, you know, cars and buses being blown sideways, the winds were fierce.
It blew bus sideways so hard, it knocked over a fire hydrant. Water went up in the air
like that, and it froze solid in the air. It was like something being in a special effect movie or something. So I'm still being blown down, keeping my balance, and, you know, coming down 7th Avenue, you know, with gale force winds, you know, blizzard winds, you know, and it's blinding snow.
And I kept getting blown down 7th Avenue. And I came to Urban League Street Academy. That's what I was looking for.
And then I get right in front of the school, and I look through the window, and Allah was on the other side, and he reached up his hand and said, Azreal!
He said, Azreal!
You know, he came running out, and he picked me up and spun me around when I hear that song by Luther, Dance with My Father Again. You know, it affects me. It's, good way, nothing said, just a good positive stroke. I feel so blessed that, you know, out of all the people, not white people, but any people on earth, he chose me. We chose each other, actually, but you don't just give this job to somebody, you know, like it's manifest destiny. You have to be born do it. And that's what I was born to do. My daddy is Clarence Puddinhead Smith, so that makes me Jack Michael Kennedy Puddinhead Jr.
And when he came to the Street Academy, the father introduced him to us and we got to know him. And it was that we looked upon him with suspicion, quite naturally. So we took him through the trials that he had to go through, from the tests that we took him through, to embrace him. The nature of those tests first was the lessons. Did you really master the student enrollment in 10 minutes? And his truthful statement was that he didn't recall.
I had screen mathematics and alphabets, and the student enrollment was 10 minutes flat. You know, I remember a lot of the father told him I got it that quick. And the small lessons I didn't need him to write down. was only the medium and large lessons I did. As soon as I learned them, I destroyed them. Because at that time, we want the guards to get a hold of our lessons.
You know, we examine the things that we heard about him, all right? Observing him and seeing his, you know, ability to be righteous, that this is a culture scene. We was taught the white man the devil, so we think he's going to sooner or later do some wicked shit around us, some wicked things around us. And watching him to see if he would, you know, tell a lie, steal, try to master the written man, or even cause some confusion. He didn't do none of those things. The first day, the second day, the first week, the second week, the first month, the second month, the first year, the second year, the first decade, the second decade, he didn't do none of those things. And here to the third and the fourth decade, he didn't do none of those things. He didn't lie, he didn't steal, he didn't cheat. He didn't accuse the righteous of anything that caused them to fight and kill one another. You know, and he did everything in his power to do and act like a written man.
Because he ain't nothing to me. And see, I always look at a man for his ability. If the father gave him knowledge, what is he doing with it? He ain't doing nothing with it. It's just wasted knowledge. He's around here like a pig, scrounging off rats, you know, little bits and parts of everything, begging, doing negative stuff. And the people praising him, ain't nothing to praise that about.
But the guards treat Azreal very responsibly, very respectfully, and very righteously. But there are some, and it's real, that may come in our name and not really be God and don't measure up to the treatment of others like a true and living God.
Yo, yo, yo. Knowledge is to know, listen, observe, and also to respect. Knowledge is the foundation of all things in existence, such as the sun is the foundation of the solar system, and the Asiatic black man is the foundation of his family. It's nice to be important, but it's even more important to be nice. It's nice to be important, but it's even more important to be nice. It's my word. It's nice to be important, check, but it's even more important to be nice. Karma makes one sacrifice. What?
Hey, yo, man, you got a problem, man. You want to be me. I know what that is. But I'm going to tell you something. Allah is a God, man. And I'm not going to be on camera. Like, no, see, that's where you got it wrong. So you've been away too long. My name is Jalal Bill. Now, the reality, hopefully one day, you'll stop dreaming and wake up to reality. How about that part? Now, what the hell is wrong with you? What the fuck? You looking like some goddamn Jimmy Crack Corn, and I don't care. What the fuck is up with you, man? What the fuck is up with you, man?
His teacher was old man Justice, and mine was real close to real. He has had us the last part of Az.
Peace. Peace. Allah the God.
Always has and always will be.
I don't know who else heard it, but the story I heard from the father, and I remember, was that he was shot from a high-powered rifle from the balcony of the St. Teresa Hotel.
That's the balcony right over there. And he was standing in some doorway. He didn't say what doorway, and I didn't ask. And the bullet went through his back and into his shoulder, and it lodged next to his heart.
1/3 inch next to his heart, and they couldn't take it out.
When he went in an ambulance, that's when he was still Clarence 13X.
As he was losing consciousness in the ambulance, he said a prayer. He says, "Oh Allah, if I should die, who will save the children?" And when he regained consciousness, he manifested himself to Allah.
That was probably his, you know, the same incident that he wound up going to Madawan, because when they arrested him, he said he was Allah. And they sent him to Bellevue sent him to Madawan.
What else is the question?
That's you. Go ahead, get that.
Hey, yo. How old are you?
Huh?
How old are you?
How old am I?
Yeah.
I'm 16 years old.
16? Oh,
you look a lot older.
Damn, yo. Yeah. I'm going to see you, though. I'm going to see you in like 2 years or something.
All right,
peace.
He looks like a grown up girl.
16, boy, that's right, huh? Boy, you're scoring big, ain't you? Only 16, only 16, and she made my heart glow. She was too young to fall in love, and I was too young to know. Sam Cooke again, how about? She was too young to fall in love, and I was too young to know.
Yo, she was bad though.
But you see how the message fits. It's always in the fucking music.
Come on, man. I'm with some Cypher, man.
I didn't say that. I'm just showing and proving that, in other words, I can do that. I can pull a song that makes it fit the situation. You know, it's showing and proving the life lesson that it taught me, that it ain't just bullshit, that it's real. And the music's on time. That's when you feel the mathematics unfolding. I'm right on the verge of finding us in the Book of Notre Dame. I got it in my bag. And it says in the Book of Notre Dame about us, and the ones of seven will come in the last days, not the last days of the earth, the last days of the age of Pisces. The New Testament is based on the zodiac, and it's about the age of Pisces, the age of the fishermen. Jesus was a fisherman and taught men how to be the fishermen of men. You know, and then they perverted whatever it was he taught. He taught just what Buddha and Muhammad taught, the brotherhood of man, but their followers went to war with each other. And religion is the reason for all those wars. You know? In order to get back the good things that he taught, you always had to go past, you know, the fact of losing him, seeing him laid out, you know, in unity, watching him put his body in the oven up there. I didn't want to continue. I didn't want to be in a world without him. I even told him, what am I going to do? Everybody else got 7.5 ounces. I said, even if I'm right and exact, how am I going to deal with this? They're wrong, and he got 7.5 ounces wrong. How am I going to deal with it? He says, Azreal, as long as you're right and exact, the truth will repel their lie, or they will repel themselves. The intent of assassinating him was just like Malcolm. You cut the head off of the body supposed to fall. But when they cut a lot out of his physical, the head didn't fall off. Another 100,000 heads grew, you know, and it just keeps growing. You know, there was one time me and Father and Old Man Justice were behind school and we smoked some equality. And after we'd done smoking in the yard of school, we went in front of the school. So this is a couple of weeks or at least a month before the Father went to his essence. And he was always very serious and you know, like, I didn't have no time to laugh about nothing, and I could, I could always find a way to get him to laugh, you know, I'm pretty good at it. After we smoked, I'm standing here, Father's standing where you are, and Old Man Justice is standing next to him. So I said, okay, you're alive, the Father, and you're Justice, the Son, what does that make me? The Holy Ghost like that. I did the 360, the movie taught me. When you get in danger, it's 4 feet or less. And so when I did that, they both started laughing real hard. Old Man Justice went down belly laughing. So the Father and Old Man Justice busted out laughing, belly laughing. And all the young 5% in the school came running out. And they wanted to know real quick what the joke was, what was making the Father laugh so hard. But we were laughing so hard we couldn't tell them. And they were getting angry about that. And the angrier they got, the funnier it got, because now we really couldn't stop laughing. So, you know,
I don't remember when we stopped laughing, but it was a big laugh, big. I was glad I could get that laugh for him. It was like, he was so serious. So pay attention, I ain't gonna be here. I'm going home. He called the essence going home. Because half of me is in the wall with them, and the other half is out of here with you. So you can't find work, invent a job. Hey, grab a broom and sweep till somebody pays.
He take care, he's a good caretaker of the very property that the father had established for us. He take pride in doing all of these things, and he is a worker. The one thing you can never deny about Azreal is his ability and willingness to do work. He is not lazy, as some trifling brothers are. They are actually lazy. They have no get up and what? Go. A man that don't have a get up and go is a man that really don't care about himself, and actually a man lacking knowledge of himself. Azreal care about himself, he has knowledge of himself, and that's maybe his motivating factor to have get up and go.
Go ahead, yo, sing that song.
Oh yeah. When the night has come and the day is done, yeah, and the moon is the only light you'll see. Boom, 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 boom. If the sky we look upon should crumble in Katrina, and California will fall in the sea. Boom, 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 boom. And Atlantis, it'll rise on America's southeast side. Golden riches coming from ancient Atlantis. Then the rich will jump in the ditch without their money and their honey. They're what? Nothing, honey. Ha! No more reason to live. Just die. Ha! All right. Hey, there it is. I, and then a rap group asked me, hey, can you rap? I said, well, I can talk a little. So they said, can you make a song? I said, well, we'll go. Timex, Rolex, Malcolm X, the day has come to do the father's will. Arm a leg, a leg, a arm a head, get the job done. Don't be a son, be a father, be a brother. If you're nine or more, ha, you gotta be a man. Ha! Peace. That's how peace out here.
All right, can I see some of this?
You want to see it? All right.
I'm the only one who's seen it.
I wanna go outside in the rain. It may sound crazy, but I wanna go outside in some rain. I know to you might sound strange, though how I wish that it would rain, 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 while the rain can't hide your teardrops when it comes straight from your heart. I wanna go outside in that rain. Let me go, let me go, let me go. That song probably came from prison, man. It really meant, I wanna go outside in the yard. It ain't that hard, Mr. Turnkey. All you gotta do is let me go outside in that yard. When the rain, I mean,
But I'm hit you in the head without you, darling. You know I'm dead. I wanna go outside. Let me go, let me go, let me go. In the rain. The mist I'm crazy, but I wanna. And then he goes, for all the gods and the nation gods of earth, this is for you. I'm so proud of you. Oh, yeah, yeah. And I'm so proud of you. Oh, yeah, yeah. And I'm so proud of being loved by you. And it would say all the world couldn't change. I'm so proud. I'm so proud of you. Oh, yeah, yeah. And I'm so proud to be here. It's just another Saturday night, and I ain't got nobody. I got the money, but I didn't get paid.